All right, so we're going to go over some of the notes from section 2.5 that I was hoping to cover in class. So we're following along doing some of the activities. These are also posted in Canvas, the activities from 2.5. So in case this isn't clear, we're doing 2.5, and we're talking about the second derivative. So based on our breakout room work in class, what we kind of summed up here is if f is increasing, then we know that the first derivative is positive on that interval. If f is decreasing, then the first derivative is negative. Now the new information is about the second derivative. So if our original function f is concave up, then the second derivative is positive. And if the original function is concave down, then the second derivative is negative. So let's kind of apply these observations that we sort of saw in the previous activity to how can we use this knowledge now about the second derivative. So again, you want to really read carefully what you're given and what you're being asked about. So here we're given graphs of the original functions, and they're asking us about quantities for the first or second derivative, or sometimes the function values. We want to read really carefully. So we're going to do just a few of these problems, and then you can finish up the ones we don't do on your own and check them in the solutions. So the first one, part A, is for f prime. So I'm looking at the graph that's f, and I want the derivative at 1. And they're just asking positive, negative, or 0. So the derivative is the rate of change. Here's where x is 1. So now I'm looking if the graph is increasing or decreasing. The graph is increasing there, so the first derivative would be positive. Then they're asking about the second derivative. The second derivative tells me if the original graph is concave up or concave down. If I'm looking close to 1, this graph is concave down because the rate of change is getting smaller and smaller and smaller, right? If I draw these tangent lines, they're getting flatter and flatter. So the actual slope is getting smaller, meaning the first derivative is decreasing. That's what gives me that concave down. So if my function's concave down, the second derivative would be negative. Doing the same thing, continuing on at 2, I'm still looking at function f. The derivative at 2 should be negative because my graph is decreasing. Now I'm starting, this is still at negative 2, and this is where we're going to need some more tools to find these points exactly. But I can see that here my graph is concave down, and then over here my graph is concave up. So the question is going to be, where exactly does it switch from concave down to concave up? From eyeballing it, it looks to me that it switches from concave down to concave up right around 2.5, right? That's when it looks like I can see the graph kind of has a little curvature in it, right? It's kind of going down, and then it switches direction, switches directions there. So at 2, I would say that graph is still concave down, so the second derivative would be negative. And the rest of these questions with f are going to be the same. Let's jump over and look at some of the ones with g. So now I'm looking at g. G is a linear function. So we already saw a pattern in a linear function. Since the slope is constant, the derivative is also the same value at every single point. So this slope is negative because the line is decreasing. So the first derivative anywhere on g would be negative. So certainly at 3, the derivative is going to be negative. Since this graph has no concavity, the second derivatives everywhere would be 0. H is also a linear function, but it's a constant function, meaning the output stays the same. So the rate of change is 0. So the derivative everywhere on H would be 0. So the second derivative is also 0. K and L are just a reminder to read carefully. That's just our function notation from algebra, so that just means what is the output when the input is 1 for f. So if I go to f, when x is 1, it looks like y is 1, so that would be the number 1. Certainly it's positive. They only wanted me to answer positive, negative, or 0 because the graph is above the x-axis. If I look at h of 1, sorry, that was g, h of 1 is below the x-axis, so that output value is negative. Specifically, I can see that it's negative 1. So that's how we can look at original graphs and determine the sign of the first and second derivative. And number two, we're kind of putting this to a context. What does this tell us about actual problems? So here we have someone in South Dakota cruising along a highway, I-90, speeding up. So that's how we see from the graph. The velocity, which is feet per second, is positive. So they're always moving forward. And here their graph gets steeper and steeper and steeper. So the velocity is getting bigger, right? He's speeding up. And somewhere right around two, it looks like this graph starts curving down. So he's still moving forward. He's still increasing his speed as time goes by, but at a slower rate. And I can see that from the graph flattening out, and then it gets flatter and flatter and flatter. So the question is, on what intervals would the derivative be positive or negative? Well, the first derivative just tells me if my function's increasing or decreasing. This function is always increasing, so the first derivative should always be positive for that entire interval. But now in part B, it's talking about the second derivative. So the second derivative, which in this case would be acceleration, right? If the units of the first derivative, using our new notation, that would be the change in distance over change in time. That's feet per second. So the second derivative is going to be my change in my first derivative. So I'll say df prime, also over change in time. So that's feet per second which we sometimes write as feet per second squared, right? So that's acceleration. So the second derivative is the acceleration. How much faster is he going faster? So in this case, I'm looking for concavity. So here, it looks like he keeps getting faster and faster and faster. The graph is concave up. The first derivative is positive, and it's getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. So where it's yellow, it's concave up, so the second derivative should be positive. And then after 2 seconds, it looks like he's slowing down. Right? The graph is still increasing. Feet are getting bigger as seconds go by, but they're getting bigger at a slower and slower rate. And that looks like the graph is concave down. So his acceleration is going down. So I would say that the second derivative is going to be positive when t is between 0 and 2. That's when the graph is concave up. And then the second derivative will be negative when t is bigger than 2, when the graph is concave down. When the graph is positive, the second derivative means he's accelerating. And if the second derivative is negative, his velocity is still positive, but he's decelerating. He is slowing down. He's still moving forward, but he is slowing down. And then the last, if I can get to my next screen here that I wanted to show you, maybe not. Then the next thing we wanted to look at, I'll come over here and grab it, is some more practice with sketching. So we're just going to do one quick sketch here, and this is what we're going to pick up in class tomorrow. So I can kind of put all these things together for myself to think about what a graph would look like. And I said one quick sketch, but I'm actually going to do two. So let's see if I can move this over to where we can see it and make it bigger. Oops, that's not the one I wanted to make bigger. Here it is. There we go. All right, so let me just get rid of this. Sorry. All right, so the idea here is to kind of think about what things mean. So if my function's increasing, as I move from left to right, it has to be getting higher and higher. That the function is bigger than 0 means it's positive, so it's always above the x-axis. And that the first derivative is increasing, that means that's the same thing as saying the second derivative is positive. So my graph is concave up, always getting higher as I move from left to right, and totally above the x-axis. So one possibility could be something like this. Concave up, increasing above the x-axis. And the second graph, again, my graph is positive, so it's always above the x-axis. But now I want the graph to be decreasing. The second derivative is positive, again, means it's concave up. So it's above the x-axis, decreasing, concave up. So it's going to have to look something like this. There might be more than one way to sort of show what a graph like this might look like, but it would have to meet all of those criteria. Hopefully this helps summarize a little bit about what the second derivative tells us, and we'll be doing more with that tomorrow.